Good to see you. My name is Elliot Morgan.
I'm Joe Beretta, SourceFed.
So new scientific evidence found by scientists suggests one particular scientist may have had a correct scientific theory like 100 years ago.
And that is as concise as our understanding of this stuff gets. You're welcome.
Hope you took notes.
Test on Tuesday.
That's today.
Get out your books then, kids, or paper, or whatever kids take tests on today. Your tablet or iPhone or Star Trek phasers, I don't freaking know.
Basically, which is a word I use when I'm about to overgeneralize the crap out of something, astronomers have found evidence of gravitational waves, the existence of which was theorized by Albert Einstein as part of his whole general relativity idea. If found to be true, these gravitational waves prove the Big Bang Theory, which, guys, gets like 26 million viewers an episode.
And got renewed for 3 seasons.
So you see where our interests lie.
We don't watch it. Said gravitational waves, the existence of which have never been confirmed, were found by a team of space people from the Harvard-Smithsonian Center for Astrophysics. This discovery suggests that the Big Bang, which is theorized to have happened in the first billionth of a trillionth of a trillionth of a trillionth of a second, lol, caused the universe to expand at faster than the speed of light.
And you might be thinking, but wait a minute, faster than the speed of light goes against Einstein's theory of special relativity, but like, obviously it doesn't, because this was an expansion of space itself, as opposed to something taking place within space. It's like the fact that I even have to explain this to you guys.
Yeah, it's called inflation. Ever heard of it? Now, the discovery here that we're discussing was found by finding a twisting pattern in the, quote, polarization of the cosmic microwave background known as a curl or B-mode pattern.
If we could please now show the picture that smart people would understand.
There it is. These waves are, quote, primordial space-time ripples. God, I love big ripples.
Really? I prefer smaller ripples myself.
Like, give me a coin. Nickel-sized ripples, that's a good size.
My nickel size is a pretty good size. For me, as long as the ripples are the same size, I'm happy.
Totally. This new discovery has been dubbed a smoking gun and a holy grail for scientists. For us, it means exciting things because it means we get to talk about science without actually understanding it. Smart people, can you explain this to us, like, for 5 or 3 in the comments down below? And if you're not smart, just keep your mouth shut. We don't want to hear any of your bullcrap.
Yeah, and like the video and subscribe to the channel, and of course we have all these cool things down here. Look at that. Oh, that's a new one. It's really great. You should check that one out. Did you turn the annotations off? You gotta turn it back on. You can't just click it, otherwise you're gonna pause the video. You gotta turn the annotations back on, click the annotation, and be good to go. My name's Elliot Morgan.
My name's Joe Beretta.
Bye.